Hi, and welcome. Today, we're going to talk about a question we get from a lot of measurement technology users. What is false signal suppression, and how does it work?
I have my own ideas about the term false signal suppression.
I know what you mean. I definitely would like to suppress my alarm clock in the morning.
Huh, right. I feel the same way.
When we're talking about level sensors, however, a false signal is a reflection that does not come from the product, and therefore isn't corresponding to the actual level.
So where do these false signals come from?
Sensors can often detect built-in components inside the tank, such as agitators or heating coils. If we look at an echo curve, it clearly shows that the sensor is picking up multiple interfering signals before the actual level signal. This type of interference also occurs with sensors mounted on sockets or ball valves.
Understood, but what can we do about false signals now?
If the interfering signals cannot be avoided by moving the sensor, we have the option of telling the sensor to ignore them. This is called false signal suppression. It can be operated via the display directly on the sensor, via the adjustment software PACTware on a PC or laptop, or via the VEGA Tools app on a tablet or smartphone. No matter which way you do it, in the end, you'll get a reliable level value.
And that's basically the goal of every level measurement.
Exactly. And fortunately, false signal suppression no longer plays such a big role, thanks to improved 80 GHz technology like we use today in our radar sensors. VEGAPULS 64 and 69. These interfering signals hardly occur anymore. Due to their extremely narrow focus, these sensors simply measure right past tank internals or buildup. And where there is no interfering signal, there is no need to suppress anything. This greatly simplifies the setup and commissioning of sensors.
So, effectively, what we have here is a sensor you can install and then forget about. I like that. So that's it for now.